SPARC program, or Special Pathogens Response Center, is a federally funded program that we have here at UNC Hospitals, and it is a part of a larger network of 13 regional emerging special pathogen treatment center sites. And essentially what we do is we have the capacity and the capabilities to accept a special pathogens patient, so somebody who has something like Ebola virus disease or Marburg virus disease, and admit them to our hospital in a specialized unit and care for them throughout the continuum of their care.
Relaying a message to you from AirCare.
Okay.
They just called, said they are leaving Duke in 5 minutes and they will call on their way with an ETA.
Okay, thank you so much for that information. I will make sure to relay this to the team.
All right, thank you.
Thank you.
So our exercise today is a full-scale exercise. It is really a accumulation of what we have put to work over the past year through training. We talk about and don our high-level PPE for caring for these patients, PPE being personal protective equipment. We wear a very specialized PPE to care for these special pathogen patients. And each quarter we do a very specialized training where we look at specific skills. How do we manage a patient's waste? How do we manage drying labs? How do we manage laboratory specimens? Things like that. And so, and also how do we manage communication and coordination of all the different parties that we need to make this come together?
When you think about what the mission is for the University of North Carolina's School of Medicine, it's really to serve the patients of North Carolina and beyond. And over the past decade, certainly, we've seen an increase in frequency and scale of outbreaks of high consequence infectious diseases. And I'm thinking about Ebola virus disease, thinking about COVID-19 in the beginning, Lassa fever, Marburg virus disease, H5N1 influenza. So there's been a number of these pathogens that have emerged and caused outbreaks around the globe. And these are things that we feel very strongly that we should be prepared to both treat and to treat safely.
So I worked in the medicine intensive care unit for 7 years, and for 2 years of that, we were activated as the COVID unit. So we all had a lot of experience working with what initially was a pretty, you know, pretty scary new infectious disease. We had to learn a lot along the way. But I think that's what makes it so important to do an exercise like this, because you can't be too prepared for something like this. And you also can't anticipate all of the barriers to care you're going to run into. So when we go through these exercises, we see a lot of things that we can improve, things that we can change to make the experience safer for the patient and everyone else involved.
I mean, I think if you think about the very early days of COVID, right, even though we saw it in other countries before it hit the United States, there was incredible amounts of fear. And I would say that we were not as prepared as we should have been for that type of disease to come into our doorsteps. And so what we're trying to do now is get ahead of it. While there is no threat in the state of North Carolina, our job is to keep the people of North Carolina safe and to provide care for them when they need it.
An outbreak or a pathogen is always a plane right away, or only a plane right away, I guess I should say. That is a famous quote from our medical director in infection prevention, Dr. David Weber. He loves to always say that anything is a plane right away. So we want to make sure that we are always prepared and always in a state of readiness to take these patients.
It's a worst case scenario. And sure, we hope we never have to be activated, but if we are, we'll be ready.